Now we want to answer the second question. Is this grammar LL1 grammar? That means, can you do a deterministic LL1 parsing with this grammar? And that means if you know from which variable you want to derive next and you know the next input symbol from the string, do you exactly have only one possibility for picking the next rule? For example, if you have the starting symbol and you know that the next symbol from the input is an A, do we have only one possibility of a rule to take, or could you take both of them, and then you have to try out both and you can't do it deterministic. So what we have to do is to compare the first sets of the right rule sides. So you have to compare this, that are the first sets of the right sides of S, and you have to compare the right sides of B, and that would be this two. So, as you can see here, you have in B, you don't have any common symbol. So that is okay. Disjunct. Oh, that wasn't very pretty. But if you compare this first set, then you have a common member in it. You have in both, you have an A. That means if you have the starting symbol and you know that the next input is an A, you could rather take this rule or you could take that rule, because both of them can give you an A. So that means these sets are not disjunct. And that means no, this grammar is not LL1 parsing, because you have cases where you don't know which rule to choose and you can't do deterministic LL1 parsing with it. And the reason why we calculated the follow sets, that's because we have an epsilon production, and if you don't have any epsilon production, then you don't need the follow sets. Because when you have epsilon production, you could have the following case. I give you an example. C maybe derives to, so C is an epsilon production. C derives to epsilon or A. And D derives to C and A. And that means if you have the D as next input symbol and you... I started at the other point. As you can see, the first sets, you would compare the first sets of epsilon and A, and they are totally fine because they don't have common members. But if you have the D as next variable and you want to derive an A, you could rather get then the A by deriving to C and then to that, to this A, or you could derive C to the empty string, and then this A would be the next input symbol. So if you have an A in this case, you don't really know if C would derive to epsilon or to A. So you would compare the follow set of C. This would be this one with the first set of C. So this A with this A, and if they have a common member, like in this case, then you couldn't do probably deterministic LL1 parsing as well. because of those epsilon rule. We can have a look at this as well. So if you compare, so you want to compare the first set of B with the follow set of B, and you see that you don't have common members. In the first set of B, you have B and epsilon, and in the follow of B, you have A and the dollar sign or the word and sign. So in this case, the epsilon production is not a problem, but well, this was a problem, so this grammar isn't LL1 parsing, but isn't an LL1 grammar and doesn't allow LL1 parsing. So, but you should keep in mind that if you have epsilon productions, then if you compare the first sets of the right side of the rules, then they are maybe fine, and you have to check the follow sets as well.